college. But Russell actually had me beat, so you made a 9 on 17. So my story is nothing compared to his. I only made an 8, so I'm way better than you. But I was 1998. I'll tell the background. 1998, I was in 10th place. Going into Sunday, playing with Scott Oak, who's a former, Wake Forest, alumni as well, so it's a good pairing. I had the round of my life. I had made 8 birdies going to 17. I was tied for the lead. My mother was dying of lung cancer. She was in a wheelchair every day for the tournament, being pushed around, and had never hit it in the water up to that point on 17. I was in the zone. I didn't even know how many birdies I'd made to that point. I didn't care because I knew it was around my life and I was just staying out of my way and doing what I needed to do. It's 143 yards. Russell says you never forget the yardage. 143, pins in the back right, Sunday typical pin, and I flushed it. At that point, hit a 9-iron because the balls were all marshmallows, and I flushed it. Never left the pin, stayed in the air, flew over the green in the water. And I was in shock at that point. I just couldn't believe it because my 9-iron was right at the, right in the middle of the green all the time. So then I went to the drop area. And for those people that you don't know, that the drop area is not easy because everybody walks on that drop area. All the players are walking on that drop area right through. So it's really tight grass, dropped it in a tight lie, hit it in the right bunker. The ball buried in the bunker. And now I'm like, oh my God, now I'm in a bunker, I'm a good bunker player, but this is a tough shot. I tried to hack out, and it rolled just over into the water. So now I drop in the bunker, and it buries as well. Splash out, 2-putt, and a solid 8. And that was that. So birdied 18 to finish 5th in the tournament. Made 8 birdies on that day.
Would it have been better for you, I'm being serious, if you hit a bad shot and went in the water than
flushing?
Could you live with that a little bit better if it was bad and it went in the water than put your heart's probably like
on? I'm not sure because even to this day, the times that it's brought up, I feel very, very good that I hit a great shot. So I'm cool with that. I got thousands of letters over the next couple months about, and a lot of tour players that have made a point, because that wasn't easy with being contacted. So a lot of guys came out of their way to say, look, I've been in that position, and I hit a shitty shot. I hit it 30 yards in the water, I chunked it, and at least you hit a good shot. So that was a good thing. Yeah, that was nice.
By the way, and I know him just a little bit, and many of you may even know him better, but why are they considered one of the all-time great guys out on the PGA Tour? And I know he's had to tell that story a bunch, but it's a humbling game.
Well, wasn't right. that back then was in March?
That was in March. Yeah, yeah.
Did you back that up? Wasn't that the Masters year?
That was March. My 5th year on tour, and I won 3 or 4 years later for the first time. So I had been progressing every year. I actually got better on the money list every year up until the time I won. So I just saw the natural progression. And after that tournament, it was 4 months later that my mother passed away. So it was a very, very real perspective of the game of golf is a game of golf, and life is the real deal. So it was very all-encompassing. It was very family. It was very golf. It was my career. It was very public. And that's what we teed up. We teed up. It's very public. Whether you win, lose, miss the cut, that's what we do, so that's part of the game.
It's even more public now than it's ever been, right?
Yeah.